actually studied with Cesar Franck and Charles Gounod, so some pretty cool influences right there. And he has written some individual pieces, including there's a really cool piece for flute and piano. But this piece was written for cornet and piano, and it's hypothesized that it's one of the Morceau de Concours, or the Paris Conservatory jury style pieces, and it was written in 1901. The next piece you guys are going to hear is called Variations and Fugue on a Theme by Brahms. This piece was written in 2012 by Erika Wiesen, and it's actually my favorite Erika Wiesen piece of all time. This piece was commissioned by Chris Decker to commemorate the loss of his father. Chris Decker is the professor of trumpet at the University of Maryland, and almost every Erika Wiesen piece is written for Chris. But this one was written to commemorate Chris's father, who just passed. And his father was an amateur pianist and loved the music of Mozart and Schubert and Beethoven and Brahms. And when they were working together to kind of figure out what they wanted to do exactly, they decided to use the theme from Opus 117, number 1, the piano intermezzo. And so you'll hear Camilla start with that, and then it's going to take some interesting turns on the trumpet. So hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
this piece was actually originally written for you guys, and then it was stolen and played on tuba. And so I wrote Lauren and I said, have you ever considered a trumpet version? And she said, I just made one. And so I did the world premiere of this piece about a year and a half ago. It's super cool. It's definitely a little funky, but it's a bossa nova and a tango, and I hope you guys enjoy.
Thank you.
This is part of a consortium that I was a part of, and the piece starts really beautifully. It talks about a garden and how everything's peaceful. And then as we get into the middle part of the piece, we definitely have feelings of isolation and concern and depression and disappointment and things like that. And then, of course, at the end, you know, we come out on the other side. So it's meant to be a reflective experience, and definitely feel free to think about your experience during COVID and try and figure out, you know, try and hit some of those feelings, but also realize we are moving on. So I hope you enjoy Go to the Garden. But honestly, Ross was a former student of mine back in the day, and I'm so incredibly proud of him to see what he's accomplished, not only as a player, you know, here playing with the Arkansas Symphony, but just what he's doing internationally, nationally, and you guys in the Trumpet Studio are so lucky to work with such an incredible person, mentor, player, teacher. So just know that you've got it really, really good, and you should be very, very, very grateful, and you should listen to everything he says. So, and I also want to thank Brianne, who has also graciously let me into her house. So thanks, a huge thanks to them. And thank you to the Trumpet Studio for all of your work so far. I'm so excited for the class again tomorrow. But you guys have been so open and so kind, and I just hope that it's been a helpful and great experience for you all. So anyhow, we have one more.